large, gloomy house was dark, except for the light by which McGarity was reading. Outside, a storm was brewing. Inside, the painful silence held a promise of violence and death. In the distance, the first faint rumble of approaching thunder was heard. The very emptiness of the room held menace. To Inspector McGarity's alert ears, no sound was too slight to be heard. The ticking of the clock, almost in rhythm with the beating of his own heart. The wind slammed a shutter against a window. McGarity knew that the hour was at hand. Quietly, a secret panel opened in the wall behind him. Two hands with fingers curved like the claws of a predatory animal reached toward his throat. Feeling vaguely that something was amiss, McGarity glanced around. The hands withdrew. When they reappeared, they held a handkerchief to jam down his throat and snuff the breath from his lungs before he could cry out. The hair in the back of McGarity's neck began to rise. He had a premonition that the bloody hand which had struck down Sir Ogilby would strike again that night. Garrity's premonition was well-founded, for at that very moment, the murderer looking behind him was preparing to kill the famous detective in cold blood.
Ah, trash. Things like that don't happen.